Before he became the Beard, this 6'5" shooting guard made a name for himself at Arizona State University. Even though his Sun Devils didn't make it very far or play well in the NCAA tournament, after an impressive sophomore season, he was selected first team All-American and was awarded the Pac-10 Player of the Year. This was just the beginning.
With the third pick in the 2009 NBA draft, the Oklahoma City Thunder select James Harden of Arizona State University.
The Thunder, they liked James Harden all along. They considered him the most polished player in the draft. The sophomore guard from Arizona State.
The Clippers and Grizzlies might have some regrets on selecting Blake Griffin and Hashim Thabeet before Harden.
Well, James, by the reaction in the house here tonight, the indication is that you may have gone under the radar a little bit. In light of that, what do you think you need to prove?
I don't think I need to prove anything. I just need to go in there and work hard, you know, and try my best, you know, to earn a spot on that team. They're young and they're great, and they have, you know, a great chemistry right there. So I want to go there, you know, and try to help them out.
You've been described as having a very old school type of game. What do you think people mean by that?
I have different paces to my game. I'm not the fastest guy. I'm not the most explosive guy, but I get from point A to point B. And just going there and helping, you know, those guys out, you know, like Kevin Durant and Russell, you know, it's going to be a great honor.
Well, speaking of your family, before we got started here tonight, spoke to mom about the facial hair. They took a vote at the table. They're going to let you keep it. Are you going to keep it?
Maybe for a few more weeks, you know, but I might want to shave it just as, you know, to try something different, you know, start a new, maybe look younger. but I'll take that into consideration.
Harden was the third straight lottery pick for OKC. We could already see the focus and hunger of a truly great player ready to prove himself.
The first time you play against a certain someone, give me a player in the league that it's going to be like, you realize you're in the NBA, it's for real. And
I mean, any two-guard, you know, I'm in the two-guard position, so every night it's going to be somebody, you know, whether it's Joe Johnson, you know, whether it's Kobe, whether it's Brandon Roy, every single night it's a different player.
Give me a player in the NBA you most want to dunk on.
Shaq.
Give me the player in the NBA you most want to, like, that you want to have your biggest game against, your first big, big game, 50-point game.
Every game.
His feel for the game when attacking the basket, combined with his deceptively quick moves, keeps defenders guessing.
The Harden that I think the Thunder are going to really like. Somebody could get out.
It'll be James Harden. Nobody's going to question his stroke.
I like him because he does things that you can't duplicate.
And here he goes at the end of the shot clock up and gets in rhythm. Knows how to get a shot off.
I'm glad to have him on our team. He's going to be our point guard for the future.
James Harden.
With lots of young talent, minutes were limited. But he still averaged 14.5 points, 3 rebounds, 3 assists, and just over a steal per game during his 4 games. A couple years later, the entire league learned what everyone in the Thunder organization knew. This guy is special.
You know, being drafted the 3rd overall pick, you know, most guys would come in and think, they're going to be a starter on any team, but you know, this team is definitely something special, especially with all the talent that was already here. And Scotty did a great job of making me become that sixth man off the bench, you know, and helping me, you know, figure my role out. You know, at first, you know, as a rookie, I didn't get it. You know, I just thought I was going to go in there and score and just do all the things that every other player thought. But learning 3 years it took me to embrace that role. Come in, not just score the ball, but just change the game. You know, whether it's defense or offense or just creating steals, some nights I'm not going to score, but just doing whatever it takes to win the game. And, you know, Scotty really, you know, embraced that and put that into my head. So, you know, I really appreciate him for that. And just it's a blessing. It's an honor to be the Kia Sixth Man this year. And, you know, I really thank everybody that I just mentioned for this award.
They tasted a bitter NBA Finals defeat, falling to the Miami Heat, but James took that as motivation into Team USA Ball, helping them win gold.
We came out here for one goal, you know, and from the beginning, you know, from Chicago and New York and even Gran Canaria, we had one thing on our mind, and that was to win a gold medal, and tonight was a perfect example of dominance.
You have a couple of these things now, this one in a different role for you. What does it mean? How is it different?
You know, I got a little bit more playing time, you know, but credit to, you know, my teammates. They played well. You know, Kyrie showed it tonight, how the type of player, how he's one of the best guards in the league, best players in the league. But it's been a great experience. I think all of us enjoyed it, and credit to our coaches. They've done a phenomenal job as well.
After a glimpse of his potential, he decided it was time to lead his own team.
GMs are paid to make difficult and decisive decisions, and that was made tonight in Oklahoma City. Thank you so much, Mark.
He led the league in assists last year and led the league in scoring this season. His Rockets had the best record in the league, which secured home court. That MVP trophy seems long overdue.